Maharana Pratap Foundation UK, ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to be with you, and it seems that we have all condensed the long history of Mewat into just one name, Maharana Pratap. Due to the COVID-19 situation, the event is taking place via electronic apps, and at my end too, the virus is about and we are all locked in. The signal strength here is inadequate and unsteady, and I therefore send you my recorded version in a way that it may reach you safely and leave no chance for transmission errors. I feel honored, deeply honored, to be invited to the Maharana Pratap Jayanti of 2020 as chief guest speaker, to share my views on the life of my ancestor and to try and inspire you for tomorrow and the future and the relevance of all this in our present day times. About Maharana Pratap Singh, or Maharana Pratap as he's come to be known as, I'd like to point out that the history of Mewar starts from Bapa Rawal in about 734. And thereafter, in about the 50th or a little after generation, Maharana Uday Singh Ji came and founded Udaipur. And Maharana Pratap was the son of Maharana Uday Singh Ji. That is the 54th in the generations. I wish to clarify the venerated name of my ancestor Maharana Pratap, and wish to clarify particularly the fact that his name has been misused on many occasions and canards have been spread to suit the purposes and motives of all kinds of people. It is not for me to expound and assess whether the achievements of Maharana Pratap or his shortcomings were so-and-so or so-and-so, I being the grandson. But I will just produce before you, speak before you, certain factual parts of the history and try to emphasize what I wish to convey to you. The names of the Bhils and Minas, known today as the tribals, the name of Hakim Khan Sur of the Islam faith, of Bhama Shah, a Jain Mahajan, and Jhalaman, a Rajput, are recorded for their singular achievements and as allies of Maharana Pratap. It is evident that the objective of Maharana Pratap and his policies were freedom from invaders, that included the dignity for all, regardless of caste, creed or religion or faith or any other division as such. His pursuit of things was in the defense of these principles, and the motto of the family is Jo Dhrad Rakhe Dharm Ko Tahi Rakhe Kartar, which translated means one who leads a theistic life will be looked after the Almighty, by the Almighty. I wish to bring before you a fact relating to the time scale of such beliefs. Maharana Pratap, in his days, Maharana Bhupal Singh Ji, my grandfather, as late as 1947. Please ask the older people who may still be there or their next generation, and check for yourself. When all the horrible things were happening in the division of this part of the world, the Asian thing, two nations coming into existence, a lot of ugly situations of people killing one another and all things of that kind that had happened then. But I am proud to say and recount that as a child I remember these events, that in our area, in the Mewar area, there was not one instance of one community going after the blood of another community. And till today, we seem to have a very harmonious relationship between very particularly the principally known castes who are elsewhere known to be fighting each other and all. One must bear in mind the fact that a situation in war is a different story and the situation in social life is a completely different story. If you bring incidents of war into a daily life thing, nobody can live with the other. And if you are able to in the social setup accept the fact of differences and all that, we will be the better off for all these solidarities. Continuing from my grandfather's example and what he had set as a pattern, I remember one incident of being invited not many years ago to a Bhil school here which had just been set up, and I was invited to be there with them for the celebration of the opening of this school. And an incident that I will never forget is this, which I recount before you. That one middle-aged Bhil gentleman brought me a bow and arrows and gave them to me as a present, and he was just handing them over to me, and I said, no, I will not accept them like this. So he was startled, and I said, you please put it onto my shoulder as you would for yourself. And the person was relieved that I had not refused his gift, but I had merely made an amendment of how he gave it to me. And he put it on my shoulder, he handed over the arrows to me, and I think we were the two emotionally charged people in that whole gathering of quite a few hundred people around there. I treasure the bow and arrow, and it's there. And I point it out to my guests and friends whom I think would be interested to know such a thing. And this is something that I feel that if a history of such a duration is able to go into newer generations into this sort of a feeling, I think we've got quite a few things going as a plus for us. In this case, you've been kind enough to request me to give you my beliefs in these matters and what I've learned. It's a long history, a lot of inspiration, great deeds done. I can never match them. But my beliefs are, and I will tell everybody else around, please remember this. Please do not be exploited by people who misuse the names, words like dharma, mazhab or religion, through various devices adopted by many to perpetuate their own narrow ends. Only thereafter can we apply ourselves to go as a society somewhere. It's all the more our duty through attraction, not from bullying others or forcing others or tempting others, but merely by attraction of the rest of the world towards our conduct, that they may feel that there is something nice here, worth emulating, that we may be able to make a contribution to everybody else who's open to receive such signals. We have here what we call the Sanatan Dharma. Literally translated, it means eternal principles. Eternal principles are there, given to us by the Almighty, by Mother Nature, and they will not change because of what my belief is or what your belief is. They are there as they are. And if those things, as they have been applied within the limits here with us, are also accepted elsewhere, and they are differentiated from the fact of your way of doing things and my way of doing things, which may differ, but then differences also are to be tolerated. But the basics, the principles, remain the same. And if we can understand this without throwing barbs at each other, we will be better for it. The summary that I derived, roughly what I have put before you, and I hope it will be of use to everybody, and my renewed thanks to your organization for having invited me over.